Hello everyone, welcome back to Letter of the Week series. This week I am focusing on letter T, so today I will be sharing some of my letter theme based learning activities and arrangement. So whether you are a homeschooler, a teacher, or maybe just a grandparent at home who wants to teach your children, you will be really getting some fun ideas. Alright, so let's get started with our first activity. Let's go. This is object box. So Debbie, I'm going to tell you the sound of T. The sound of T is T. Repeat after me. The sound of T is T. Yeah. T for tree. T for torch. T for teddy. T for toothpaste. T
for chain.
Yes. This is the uppercase T and this is the lowercase T. Do you want to trace this T, Debbie? So Debbie, you learned T sound, right? Now do you want to try writing T? And do you know what is this? This is actually T for T. This is T. Can I show you how to trace that, or you know?
I know.
Okay.
For this one.
Okay.
How from up?
Yes, this is how you trace it. Wow, that's awesome. Do you want to trace and write the lowercase T?
Ta-da! I make two. And I'm going to make...
This is a salt writing tray which I made with tea. And it's real fun. The kids can write on this tray or they can make some design, emojis or any shapes, and they can play. It's like a sensory play. Yes.
Ta-da!
So this card, as you can see, I just made it like so that she can trace it. It's a jute paper and it's a foam sheet. And this is just a normal waste cardboard sheet.
This is a Spider-Man. It's just like a Spider-Man.
Kind of
Spider-Man, yeah.
You made a panda?
No, I made a cat.
Oh, wow.
And I can make a wrench. I'm so excited. I'm going to do a chain puzzle.
So it's a bit challenging for you, is it?
Yeah.
You try and see which one will fit.
This one.
It's not fitting there.
It is.
Okay.
This goes here, so it will fit. And this goes here, so it will fit.
Yeah. Ah. The child is really thinking which puzzle will fit where. They're thinking how, which piece will fit where when they're trying to do this. And it's very easy to make this puzzle. I made it with thick foam sheet. I have a separate video, a short video on how to make this if you're interested in making this DIY train touch and feel puzzle. What is this, Debbie?
A traffic jam.
Traffic jam or traffic light?
Traffic light.
How many colors are there?
Red. Green. Yellow.
What does red mean?
Stop.
What does yellow light mean?
Wait.
And what about green light?
Go.
So this is how I have done. This is black foam sheet. I have cut it in a rectangular shape. It's very easy to make this. And I have put pasted red, yellow and green sheet for the lights. This is some waste foam sheet which I used. I just cut it in the shape and I pasted with the glue. And behind, as you can see, it's a bamboo kind of stick which I have pasted. These three are some, again, square piece foam sheets for the three colors. The kid can match it. It's very good for toddlers even, and they can learn about traffic lights, and later they can have their own role play and they can use it as a traffic light and they can paste it. It's a very nice toy and very easy to make.
Put the mantle. Now I'm going to count them.
How many tomatoes are there? So you have to find a clip which says 13 number.
13 number.
And you have to put it on 13 number. Yes. How many tomatoes are there?
12.
And like this she goes on. It's very easy. These cards, which you can see, I prepared it with the white thick sheets and I made tomatoes, and I made her only to color all these. She only colored all the tomatoes because my drawing is not so good. So tomatoes was something from tea which was easy for me to draw. I've just put the numbers here. Okay. And this is where I've taken this clips, wooden clips. And these are some clips and I have put the number, the correct number. There are three choices given on that card and this is the correct number. Which here you go.
Thanks.
Now let's pack it. You know how to pack it? You have to remove the clips and arrange it like that. Yes, it's very important for the kids to unpack, pack both. To pack up their toys, to pack up their activities, whatever they're doing when they finish it. Encourage the children to pack. Now let's move on to the next activity. Which one you want to do, Debbie? Okay, this one. Okay, take it. So what is this activity, you know? What does it look like, this toilet roll? What does it look like? A tunnel?
Yeah.
So you have to paint the tunnel with a toothbrush because T is also for toothbrush. So you have to paint the tunnel. This is a cardboard roll sheet. Yeah, you have to choose a color and you have to paint it. T is for toothbrush. T is for tunnel and T is for toothbrush. So that's why you are going to paint your tunnel with toothbrush. Isn't it fun, Debbie?
Yeah.
This box has some water, some cloth to wipe when they spill, and this has some tube colors, 3-4 tube colors, of so that they can pick the color of their choice. T is also for towel, so this is folding towel, practical work for her. and these are towels I have kept for different sizes. But if you are starting first, I would suggest just put one size towel for kids to start with, like a square shape, then move on to the next different sizes. But as she is doing this from a long time, so I have put different sizes of the towels for her to fold. Okay, Debbie, let's go. And you know, kids can be really excited. It's about folding towels, but they really like all this work.
This is a big towel. No.
And for towel. Kids really enjoy all this work. My daughter really loves folding clothes, and especially she wants to fold all her clothes. She doesn't want anybody to fold her clothes. And I think if we give a choice, kids really want to do all their work by themselves. They don't want to be dependent on any of us, and they want to try and do. Very good, Debbie. So T is for tape also. So this is some colorful circles I have made with the tape only, and she can place the matching tape over this, and she only colored all this thing. It's very exciting. Yes, let's start, Debbie. And she, if you have colorful tapes, you can just make it very easy. You can just take one of those tapes and just make a circle, and that's how they're learning. Some of the colors look very similar, so she is thinking which is it neon yellow or neon peach? Yeah, so nice. They find their own ways of playing, and she says, I'm gonna pack like a stack toys. And so I just recorded this. Can you tell what is this, Debbie?
Stack toys.
This is a toolbox where she likes to do some screwing and putting bowls. T is for tools, so I just gave her some role playing toy. Okay, Debbie, you want to do?
Yeah.
This is how you can screw the nuts.
I mean, this is a lollipop.
Which tool is that, Debbie?
Hammer.
Can you tell me what is this?
Hammer.
And what is this, Debbie?
Screwdriver. What is hammer? Is it the side of the wheel?
It's a very nice toy. I will definitely share the link of this toy in my description box. If you're interested, you can have a look. T is also for train. So this is train set where she's gonna play by putting the tracks together, and she always like Peppa, so this is a Peppa Pig train set. You can play. So in my arrangement, as you can see, I have put two role playing toys. One was tool set and one was train set. Hope you guys have enjoyed watching all of these activities. For more information, check the description box below, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. Bye-bye. See you later.
Bye-bye.